All right, let's go.
Jeez. One. Okay, keep it moving, keep it moving, keep it moving. Don't want to get surrounded here. Seems like that's a bad plan. Stop hitting my dog, bitch. Okay. Oh. Chainmail. Come this way. Hit him. Oh boy. Get up, get up, get up. Finish him off. Okay. Leather's fine. You're going down. There's one guy left. Stop trying to attack my dog. Where is he? No, doggy! Oh, you killed him. There you go.
Oh, have mercy, my lord.
I show no mercy to vermin. Ah!
Alright, so now we took care of the ambushers, we took care of Potty. Let me just pick up my loot and we will head back to Castle Black. Free stuff is free. Nice. Okay, next one is over here somewhere. Free coin. Cutlass. Feel kinda out of place wearing the armor of the enemy, but I think what you can get. Rusty iron helmet. Second here. Inventory. Where'd that armor at? There we go. 55. No, why would I do that? Okay, next. We cannot go through here to get to his body, so we'll go this way then. Path is blocked. Let's head back to Castle Black. Man, in one day, took care of two traitors and one rapist. And they were all our brothers.
Castle Black.
Ah, Mort, you're expected by the Lord Commander. He put me on lookout for you and ordered that you be sent to him as soon as you arrived.
Moment will have to wait a while. There are things I want to take care of before I go to see him.
Very well, Mort. One of Halfhand's men told us of the events that occurred at Icemark.
I know. Winter is coming. You may go warm yourself, Lothar. I shall go see Mormont.
Guy's freaking wearing ears. What up, Mormont? Part of me kind of wish I played this on PC so the loading screens wouldn't be very long, but the GPU on my computer fried, so not much choice there. All right.
Mine, and mine alone. If you want some, you'll have to.
Guess this place is pet friendly. Must be upstairs somewhere, if there is an upstairs.
No way it's touching my pig.
There's a staircase.
Scouts and followed them. We knew that there must have been more.
Potions merchant. No thanks.
Hey, it seems Mormont wants us.
Ooh. Take that. Not stealing, right? Nah.
Jor, Lothar told me that you wanted to see me as soon as I arrived.
Yes. One of Quarren the Halfhand's men arrived before you and told me what happened at Icemark. Have you found Poddy? Or his remains?
Poddy deserted. I tracked him down in the forest north of Molestown and managed to kill him just as he was attacking a young girl. I also took care of a couple of cutthroats I came across as they prepared to ambush passers-by.
Raiders so near to Castle Black. If only we had enough men to send more patrols deep into the gift. So, not a single one of these green boys will have survived his first day as a brother of the Night's Watch. I know enough about what happened there for now. Mors, there is another matter we must discuss. I don't know if you noticed the soldiers with the blue tabards downstairs. They're the men of John Arryn, the King's Hand.
Ah, the men you told me about before I left for Icemark. Those who came to meet me.
Yes. According to their message, they were looking for one of the heroes of Stag's Mount. You are the only one here who fits that description.
Do we know more about what they want from me?
Yes. They brought me a letter written by John Arryn. I'll let you read it. You can see for yourself what it's about.
Arryn, that sly old fox hasn't changed a whit. 15 years without a word, and all of a sudden he writes to beg a favor of me. I'm not even surprised.
Why are you receiving a personal missive from the King's Hand?
He's an old friend. We fought side by side in Robert Baratheon's rebellion. He saved my life more than once.
There is a passage that I don't understand. Mentions a girl, the darkness, and your wife, Serena. What does it mean?
Arryn is an intelligent man. This is a message only I can decipher. During the war, when we fought together, I never once used the services of a whore. Arryn knew and would tease me for it. He liked to say that I feared the darkness that lurked in brothels. I would reply that the thought of my wife was sufficient to clear away any darkness. The girl he mentions in his letter must be hidden in a whorehouse. The only one I know of nearby is in Molestown. Old Arryn knows me well. 15 years later, I'm still faithful to my wife.
It is good that you honor the chastity of our order, Mors. But are you doing it for the right reasons? Our vows are clear. We must leave behind our wives and children. If you are true to your oath, it must not be out of love for Serena, but out of respect for the Night's Watch.
I know, Jor. We have spoken of this countless times, but I am unable to forget them.
Be that as it may, he must have felt seriously threatened to write such a cryptic message. This does not bode well. I conferred with his emissary, Sir Godric Donnelly. He convinced me that his mission did not conflict with our duties. And if we help them, Arryn will convince King Robert to send us the recruits, materials, and supplies that we so sorely lack. Molestown is in the gift under the jurisdiction of the Night's Watch. You have my authorization to go there with Sir Godric.
Thank you, Jor. I will finally be able to repay my debt to John Arryn.
Remember, Mors, the Night's Watch does not interfere in politics. If, for some reason, you suspect that something is wrong, return to Castle Black.
Very well. I will go find this Godric.
Alright, he's on the ground at the Common Halls, and then we're heading into Molestown. We were just at Molestown. Well, just outside Molestown anyways. He's out here.